Mr. Speaker, I rise today with great concern for the people of New Jersey and the future of our country. Project 2025 puts our health care access at risk. The conservative pledge would impose lifetime caps on Medicaid benefits, putting coverage at risk for nearly 1 in 40 New Jerseyans. It also raises prescription drug costs for almost 500,000 residents by eliminating Medicare out-of-pocket limits. Even worse, it would block the government from negotiating lower drug prices, lining the pockets of pharmaceutical companies at the expense of our most vulnerable communities. The attacks on Medicare and Medicaid would be devastating to Black and low-income people's access to vital health care. Black women, especially Black expectant mothers, who already are facing among the worst infant and maternal mortality rates in the developed world, would face even worse outcomes. The criminalization of abortions, tracking of miscarriages and stillbirths, and restrictions on access to Plan B would impinge on the freedom of Black women to make their own decisions and eliminate their health care options. That's not all. Project 2025 would eliminate programs like Head Start, which provides critical care for child care for children, over 12,000 children in New Jersey alone. It would force 167,200 student loan borrowers to pay thousands more each year and dismantle the U.S. Department of Education, cutting vital funding for schools serving low-income students and putting nearly 4,000 New Jersey teachers and their students at risk. Project 2025 just isn't a political pledge. It's a direct attack on families, our values, and the future of our country. I urge my colleagues to stand together against the dangerous assault, and let's get back to work for the uber wealthy and mega corporations behind the 2025 agenda, but for the people. Thank you.